Welcome to Coming to Life, a one-year journey through God's Word. My name is Katie Hauck. The name Jonah is probably one you learned as a child, whether you were a believer or not. If I asked you who he was, you would likely answer, the guy in the Bible that was swallowed by a whale. Well, today I want to let you know more about Jonah, why that happened, and what the real purpose of his book is. Jonah lived sometime during the years 790 and 740 BC. He lived in the northern kingdom of Israel, mostly under King Jeroboam II, who, if you recall from a previous video, was extremely wicked, yet made the nation prosperous and successful. The book of Jonah is a prophetical book, but it is unique among the prophetical books because it only contains one sentence of prophecy. The rest of the book is the story of Jonah instead of a record of his words. Despite the out of ordinary events, this is a real historical account of things that happened to a real historical person. And it has a big message, even though it is only four chapters long. So God calls Jonah to go to Nineveh and tell them about their wickedness and encourage them to repent. Nineveh was not in Israel. It was actually the capital city of Assyria, the nation that later conquers Israel. It was the largest city in the world and the most evil. Tradition tells us this city was known for torturing people. They would pierce people with spears and leave them to die, which often took days. When you walked there along the main road, you would pass a pyramid made of human heads. This was not a place most people would want to go. Jonah definitely didn't. He actually took off in the opposite direction. I want to clarify that he did not run away because he was afraid of these people. He ran away because he hated them. They were his enemies, and he did not want to ask them to repent because they just might, and then God would forgive them and he wouldn't get to see them destroyed. Jonah attempts to flee to a place called Tarshish because that city was thought of as the end of the world during those days, and Jonah wanted to get as far away from Nineveh as possible. This is the part of the story where he gets on a boat. God sends a storm, and the ship was about to be wrecked, so the sailors call him out, and Jonah tells them to throw him overboard, where he gets swallowed up by, not necessarily a whale, but a large sea creature. I encourage you to read these chapters to see if the story you were taught as a child truly lines up with exactly what the Bible says. While in the belly of this large sea creature, where Jonah stayed for 3 days and three nights, he cries out to the Lord and agrees to go give the message to the Ninevites. So God spoke to the big fish and it vomited Jonah out of its mouth. God again tells Jonah to go to Nineveh, and this time Jonah listens. He records one single verse of prophecy to them. 40 more days and Nineveh will be overthrown. If he said anything else, it wasn't recorded. If this was all he said, it surely doesn't sound like he really wanted Nineveh to repent, does it? He didn't tell them what they were doing wrong. He didn't tell them it was God who was going to overthrow them, and he didn't even tell them how to repent. Well, they figured it out anyway. Scripture says they proclaimed a fast, put on sackcloth, and repented for their own actions and even on behalf of their animals. God saw this and did not bring on the destruction he had threatened. We are now to chapter 4, and the opening paragraph is almost shocking. Jonah becomes extremely angry. He tells God, "I know you are a gracious and merciful God, slow to anger and abundant in loving kindness, one who relents from doing harm," and basically says, "This is why I didn't want to come." He was okay with God showing him mercy and forgiveness, but not his enemies. He tells God just to kill him. That's how upset he was. Well, God questions Jonah and asks him if it was right for him to be that angry, but Jonah wouldn't answer. He leaves the city and sits just to the east, as if waiting to see if the people would fail and start sinning again, or if God would change his mind and destroy them after all. God, in his great mercy, prepared a demonstration to show Jonah how wrong he was. He made a nice little shade plant to cover him, which made Jonah very happy. But the next day, God took the plant away, and Jonah wanted to die again. His last words in this book are literally, "It is better for me to die than to live." The book isn't over, though. It ends with God speaking. God explains that Jonah's anger is unjust, and he compassionately shares his concern for the people he loves, even though Jonah cares more about the plant than them. This book was technically written as a prophecy to the Ninevites, yet its message is really for us. It is an illustration of how our anger and hate can bring us to the point that we want our enemies punished, but how God loves his people. He desires to see them saved, and he expects his chosen people to have mercy and compassion just like he has for them. There is so much packed into this little book that I don't have time to cover today, but I wanted to show you how it was about so much more than simply a man being swallowed by a whale. I hope that the information shared today helps you grasp how interesting the Bible is so that you develop a passion for reading it. I pray that as you dig into Scripture and go through your workbook, God speaks to you in exciting new ways and your spirit begins coming to life. God bless.